Good morning, children. Now this is 14th lesson, 9th class social studies. What is that 14th lesson? Democratic and nationalist revolutions in 19th century. Okay. So in the previous lesson also, previous class also, I said about this lesson. So now look at here. Here, 1848, what happened in European countries? Actually, in those days, that whole European land divided as small kingdoms. That kingdoms ruled by some kings, okay, or emperors. But listen, that all people, they mixed each other. So some people talking another one language, some people speaking another language, etc. Okay, but they are living in the two areas. So in 1848, nationalism and democratic ideals came in these European countries or European empires. What is nationalism? Nationalism means we belong to this separate area. This land is belongs to ours. So they developed these type of feelings. So that is called nationalism. Okay. Next, democratic ideals means, democracy means the power vested in the hands of the people. Okay. In monarchy system, all powers vested in the hands of only one man. He is called monarchy or he is called king. So king hold all powers, judicial, executive, whatever the powers. Okay. But in democracy, that power to select the ruler, this power vested in the hands of common people. That is called democracy. Okay. So these ideas came in European countries. Next one, especially we can see these type of feelings. What are the two? Nationalism and democracy feelings. We can see in Europe, especially the lands of Germany and Italy. Germany and Italy. So here in Germany, the nation states, they want to unite each other. Okay. They want to announce this is their country, etc. Okay. Especially in those days, okay, the middle class people, they developed because they educated, they are doing jobs. Okay, so that is why they are questioning the authority of monarchy. Okay, so next one, they wanted elections to the government. In this way, they asked the right to vote. Okay, so the parliament, who are electing members, they are in parliament. Through parliament, the ruler will be ruled the country. So that ruler also will appoint by the parliament members. The parliament members will appoint by the people. That means they are representatives. So they are demanding this type of system in Germany. Here, but this is common people idea and their desire. But in Germany, many landlords are there. That landlords are called Junkers in Prussia. Okay, Junkers, these landlords. So landlords always encouraging the rule of monarchy. Okay, but the middle class people are encouraging about the formation of parliament. That means they want to elect members to the parliament. That parliament members will elect to the ruler to rule the country. So that is why middle class people are majority people. Junkers are here minority. That means they are the landlords in Prussia. Okay. But these landlords are encouraging monarchy system. That means king. Okay. So that is happening. But here in Germany, Otto von Bismarck. So Bismarck came as leader. So with the help of army and bureaucracy. With the help of army and bureaucracy, Bismarck wanted to unify the whole Germany, who are speaking that language and also who are the living in German area, etc. Okay, that means the unification of Germany has been completed by one man. That man name was here Bismarck. How Bismarck unified the Germany? With the help of army and also bureaucracy. In this way, he had to fight, that means he declared war, three wars against some neighboring countries. What are the countries influencing over Germany land? Okay, the countries are here, Austria, Denmark, France. Austria, Denmark, France. So these people are encouraging, might be encouraging the monarchy system. But here, with the help of this army and bureaucracy, the Bismarck had to fight against Austria, Denmark and France. So finally, after three wars, that means against these three countries, so finally Bismarck won, 1871. Okay, so he announced Prussian ceremonial king as William I. Okay, who was the king here, Germany, unified Germany, William I. Next one, they modernized the old system, okay, in banking, currency, next to legal, judicial system. So whatever the system was going on before the unification of Germany, after unification of Germany, so he concentrated, okay, upon the banking system, education system, okay, each and every department, even judiciary system also. Okay, so that is happening. So this is about Germany unification. It was done by Bismarck. Okay, children, now next country in Europe is, I already wrote here, Italy. What was that country? Italy. This is also in Europe. Okay, so actually the unification of Italy, so who worked for the unification of Italy? So here, 19th century Habsburg Empire, it is under the control of Habsburg Empire. Okay, so actually in Italy, seven states are there. Okay, so these seven states, north some states, middle some states, or center some states, south some states are there. But each region under the control of a separate king, but they did not belong to Italy country. Okay, for example, I wrote here, Sardinia, Piedmont, these are the states in north. Okay, so Italy princess, it was ruled by Italy princess. So these two parts in Italy ruled by Italian princess. Okay, but what about the north position or north region ruled by Austrian Habsburg? What was Austrian Habsburg? Next to center, the Italy center was ruled by Pope. What about the remaining south? So here south part is ruled by Bourbon kings of Spain. So they belong to Spain. They are the kings of Spain. These Spain people are ruling the south part of Italy. Okay, that the kings are Bourbon kings. Okay, so that means here Italy was divided as regions or states. These all states are ruling by different kings from different countries. They did not belong to Italy. Okay, so that is here we can observe. Next one, in 1830, Joseph Mazzini belongs to Italy. So he started one party that is called Young Italy. What it is called? Young Italy. So when he started this one, many young people below 40 years, that all students and the young people joined in this party, Young Italy, and they strive for the unification of Italy with the leadership, under the leadership of Joseph Mazzini. What is his name? Joseph Mazzini. Next one. So their PM, Count Cavour was their PM. Okay. Next one. Victor Emmanuel II was their king. Okay. Victor Emmanuel II was their king. In this way, they had to fight with these all who here Bourbon kings. Next one, Sardinia Piedmont, Italian prince. Next, North Porto, Austrian Habsburg dynasty king, etc. So they had to fight with these all different kings. So finally, they succeeded for the unification of Italy. Among them, Garibaldi also important leader here in Italy. Okay, so he also went with along with his troop to the south part and he captured the south part. So finally, the unification of Italy has been completed in 1871. So then they announced Victor Emmanuel II was their king. Okay, so when the unification was completed, so they saw the Italian people, majority people are illiterates. So they didn't know what was going on in Italy. A few people, they knew how Italy was unified and how the other countries or other empires or kings are ruled that country. Okay, so anyhow, finally, the peasants, the majority peasants supported Garibaldi to occupy the south part of Italy. So next one, they announced their king is Victor Emmanuel II and the PM is Count Cavour. But many people, they didn't know Victor Emmanuel II wife. What her name? La Talia. What her name? La Talia. So students, this is the two states or two nations. Okay. What are the two nations here or countries? Germany and Italy. So Germany unification completed by Bismarck. Ottoman Bismarck. Next one, Italy unification. Here two important leaders are there in Italy. I said already, Joseph Mazzini, he started Young Italy. Many youth below 40 years joined and they strive for the unification of Italy. Next up, Mazzini after Garibaldi. Okay, so Garibaldi also, so he went with along with his troop and occupied the Southland. So finally, they united the Italy and they announced their country is so and so, etc. Okay, children. Now I want to show you some pictures in this lesson. You come to the page. Page number 182. Now look at how the European countries. Here, unification of Germany between 1866 to 1871. Okay, how look these regions, all regions. Once again, after this lesson, you observe this index and what are the color information in this map. Okay, now children, once again, look here. Joseph Mazzini and the founder of Young Italy in Bern, 1833. Print by Giacomo Montegaccia. Okay, so this is the picture of Joseph Mazzini. Next one, look, I said about Italy. So this is Italy. So look, these are the states. Okay, these are the states. Look at your textbook, Italian states before unification of 1858. This is before 1858. Okay. So this is the Italy. Italy locates in Mediterranean Sea. This is Mediterranean Sea. Sardinia. Okay. Cyprus, Sicily, Crete. These all islands are there in Mediterranean Sea. This is Italy. Penetrated into the Mediterranean Sea. This is the land. Okay, children. Thank you.